بكت عيني بكت عيني بكت عيني على ذنبي وما لاقيت من كربي فيا ذلي ويا خجلي إذا ما قال لي ربي أما استحييته تعصيني ولا تخشى من العتب.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة والنخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان خلق الإنسان من صلصال كالفخار وخلق الجان من مارج من نار فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان رب المشرقين ورب المغربين فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يخرج منهما اللؤلؤ والمرجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان وله الجوار المنشآت في البحر كالأعلام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان كل من عليها فان كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يسأله من في السماوات والأرض كل يوم هو في شأن فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان سنفرغ لكم أيها الثقلان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ يا معشر الجن والإنس إن استطعتم أن تنفذوا من أقطار السماوات والأرض فانفذوا لا تنفذون إلا بسلطان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ يرسل عليكما شواظ من نار ونحاس فلا تنتصران. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ فإذا انشقت السماء فكانت وردة كالدهان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ يعرف المجرمون بسيماهم فيؤخذ بالنواصي والأقدام. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. هذه جهنم التي يكذب بها المجرمون، يطوفون بينها وبين حميم آن. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ ولمن خاف مقام ربه جنتان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ ذواتا أفنان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ فيهما عينان تجريان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ فيهما من كل فاكهة زوجان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ متكئين على فرش بطائنها من استبرق، وجنى الجنتين دان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ فيهن قاصرات الطرف لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان؟ فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ ومن دونهما جنتان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ مدهامتان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ فيهما عينان نضاختان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ فيهما فاكهة ونخل ورمان. الرحمن فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان فيهن خيرات حسان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان حور مقصورة في الخيام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان متكئين على رفرف خضر وعبقري حسان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان تبارك اسم ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام.
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ما بعد. So what did we get last week? We did the battle of Mu'tah, right? Where are we? Wallah. A little bit more. Wallah Riyadu Salihin. Which hadith were we on? Always after travel, I'd forget. Where was it? You'd have to remind me, huh? Subhanallah. 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 The note taker was exposed. Subhanallah. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, I have no words prepared. This whole weekend has made me speechless like I've never been for the longest time. Subhanallah. 12 years ago, your community took a risk and some graduate student in Connecticut. And it was a risk for me and it was a bigger risk for you. And I had no idea what I was getting into. It was my first job after leaving chemical engineering. It was my first job. I was very worried, very nervous. You were taking a big risk. Testing, testing. Some things don't change. Where's Hasnain? We need to blame him, huh? Walla Mustafa is gone now, huh? They can't hear. The new AV guy. Testing, testing. This one you can hear? Okay, khalas, afterwards deal with it. There is no afterwards. This is it. Khitamuhu misk. This is the final time, alhamdulillah. So I was saying 12 years ago, your community took a risk in a much younger graduate student who had not even finished his PhD, who was worried and terrified. How is he going to take care of his wife and four kids? Where is he going to go? What is he going to do? Who didn't want to work under some brutal board that would be disrespecting him, as many imams and shuyukh are. And the board said to me, and alhamdulillah, most of you are still here in this community, that we guarantee you that you shall be respected here. And wallahi, they lived up to that more than I could ever have imagined. And those years that I was here, Allah tested me to give me global fame. It's a big test. But you invested in me when I didn't have that fame. And you brought me here when I was still struggling to make sense of the world. And it was through Allah's blessings here in this community, at this table, that Allah tested me with this extraordinary, I don't deserve it, but the respect that people give me, not because of me, but because of the seerah lessons that I gave over here. Wherever I go, this is my hallmark lecture, even though it has been a decade almost. But, and I believe I have given types of quality works in terms of the research. We're not just different. Nothing can compare, but obviously I'm more mature now than I was then. And the types of research I'm doing is very different and in some ways more advanced. But it's the seerah that touches the hearts, isn't it? It's the seerah that comes here. And where did it take place? Right here, at this very cloth. At this very table, on this very chair, which is now tattered and broken, in this very audience. The chair is different. Okay. So So my springboard to fame, and it is not something I deserve, I'd be the first to say this, but I will never forget that it happened from here. This was the launch pad. And this setting is global. This setting over here is global. Trademark. Everybody knows it. Subhanallah. So what I owe you, all of you, cannot be measured, because it was your trust in me that I did not deserve, that allowed me to flourish for this many years, to give me that freedom to be who I was, to find myself, to travel, to research, to teach. And yes, it was with great sadness that life has to move on. But a piece of my heart is left in this community, and it is always going to be here. And I don't say that lightly. What I owe to you, only Allah can repay back. And I miss this community immensely. And I miss Naseem Aunty, who would always be sitting right there. Right there, she would be sitting all the time. And Fawzi Bhai, always the chair he would have over there in the corner. And others who have moved on and passed on, who will no longer be with us. But as I said, and subhanAllah, I gave the first khutbah in this member, the first khutbah. When I moved here, we were praying in the church, remember? This was not yet even open. And we gave, in the Germantown complex, we'd give the first khutbahs for I think 1 month or 2 months. And we would pray in the church. And then heart song, the first Ramadan, we started over there, right? And then we opened up over here that first year. How many of you remember from that time? Remember, subhanAllah, how many of you were there? Yes, look around, see how many of you are still from that batch, that initial batch, subhanAllah. And I remember the first khutbah, because it was a new masjid, and it was, we thought, far away from the city. We had 4 or 5 sufuf. I remember that, 4 or 5 sufuf, that's all we had. Because it was, who's gonna come all the way, you know, in this, you know, Cordoba, who's gonna come all the way here? But subhanAllah, slowly but surely. And then when Ramadan came along, I remember speaking to the board, I said, leave this to me. 3 recipes for a good Ramadan. Remember this, I said, short and sweet, good qari, and ilm in the middle. I remember this. And the board said, it's yours, you take charge. You gave me that trust, subhanAllah. And you allowed me to, inshallah, demonstrate for you the perfect combination. This is the Ramadans we had here. I don't think I'm ever going to have them again. Those Ramadans, and still I meet people who were here in these Ramadans. In fact, even, you know, my parents wouldn't come in the beginning of Ramadan because they liked it. One Ramadan, my parents came here. And after that, my dad said, every Ramadan, we're going to do it here now. And if you remember, every Ramadan, he would come. My own mother and father didn't trust me that much as you guys did. We don't want to come. I said, Iqbal, just come once. The first time they came, khalas, they were hooked. You know, one of the Saudi brothers that was doing his PhD here, he lives in Mecca now, right? He was doing his PhD. He texted me, Ya Sheikh, I missed the Ramadans of Memphis. I said, Astaghfirullah. Could you talk? He's just like blasphemy. He goes, la, la, la. Yes, Mecca's Mecca, but the Ramadans of Memphis, there was something special. This is somebody living in Mecca. One of the Saudis, I forgot his name, but one of the Saudis did his PhD here. Subhanallah. It really was a magical era. And I have a lot of sweet memories that decade that I spent here. And it was a very good portion of my life, my kids' life, Alhamdulillah. But still, as I said to you in the last talk I gave here, the project is bigger than individual. I'll say the same thing tomorrow again, so this is a precursor. The project is bigger than individuals. I cannot imagine an MIC without Naseem Aunty. Many of you could not imagine MIC without me. I understand this. But the project is always bigger than individuals. That is the way we have to think about these things. And people come and people go. But the message and the responsibility and the legacy needs to be carried on. Maybe, nobody can fill my shoes, even though Sheikh Faqih's shoes size are 3 sizes more than mine. Okay? He has a different set of shoes, so my shoes are too small for you, is what I'm trying to say. For sure, None of us can fill Naseem Aunty's shoes. None of us. Wallahi, I cannot imagine Taraweeh and Iftar and Suhoor and those last 10 nights she would come at Asr and spend all the way until after Fajr. How is this going to take place? I don't know. But you know what? Somehow, it's going to be modified. It's not going to be the same. That era is gone. But somehow, the legacy is going to continue. And a new generation is going to come. And they're going to pray Taraweeh here. And they're going to be taken care of their iftar and their suhoor. And memories and legacies and stories and myths and legends will remain. But the project must continue. Because this is the reality of life. In any case, I don't have any lecture to give, and that was the lecture I gave. Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, I am very, very happy to be back. Sad at the circumstances, nostalgic at the memories that it all brings back. But we thank Allah for the blessings of Islam. We thank Allah for the blessings of brotherhood. We thank Allah for life, for those who have it. And for those who have moved on, we thank Allah they gave us what He gave us. We thank Allah that He gave us what He gave us for so many years. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah ala kulli hal, alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li hadha, wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. We thank Allah, falahu alhamdu fil ula wal akhira, walahu alhamdu fis samawati wal ard. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifuna, wa salamun ala al-mursaleen, wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Any Q&A, huh?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. On behalf of all of you, inshallah, I just want to say to Sheikh Yasir, Jazakallahu khairan jazak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah azza wa jalla bless your family. I want to also thank your wife, Ammar, for being able to put up with you. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every single one of your children as well, and your parents. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and reward them and make you, inshallah, qurra ta'ayni lahuma. Now, with this, we come to the conclusion of tonight's program, right? This was the last official jama'ah prayer to be held in this musalla, a musalla that, mashallah, had its own golden age with Sheikh Yasir Qadi, hafizahullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward everyone for their role. And I believe, as Sheikh Yasir said, you know, the project is bigger than individuals, but each and every single one of you has his place and a space. The space that you occupy right now is a very special place, because without your presence, without your participation, without your contribution, without your support, none of this would have been possible. For that, Jazakumullahu khairan. Continue to be amongst those who maintain the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Continue to be of those who support the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember, Naseem Aunty's wish always was to fill the place with believers. And she would welcome everyone here. So let's, inshallah ta'ala, keep that legacy going as we transition, inshallah, into the new building officially, right? We've been, of course, there for a long time. So with that, inshallah ta'ala, I personally want to, inshallah, conclude tomorrow night. We'll recite Surah Al-Rahman, inshallah, over there. Inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Inshallah. And we'll take a selfie. Please do not go. I would love to take a selfie with Sheikh Yasir and everyone in the background, inshallah ta'ala.
Jazakallahu khair, Sheikh Baqi, and jazakallahu khair, Sheikh Yasir. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I remember I moved the same year you moved, and we prayed together in hard songs. And Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullahu khair. We thank you from the bottom of our heart. We grew up with you. We learn from you. And it's beautiful to see that relationship develop. Jazakumullahu khair. We want to give you a small piece of MIC, the same rag carpet here on the floor. We want you to remember that, inshallah, bin Rahman, Jazakallahu khair. Yes, inshallah, bin Rahman. So just want you to remember us, inshallah. And yeah, jazakallah. Yes, inshallah.
In your library, inshallah, you pray.
It's there.
Inshallah.
This is the best gift, literally a piece of MIC.
Yeah, inshallah. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
You know what? I need to.
فيا ذلي ويا خجلي إذا ما قال لي ربي أما استحييته تعصيني ولا تخشى من العتب وتخفي الذنب عن خلقي وتأبى في الهوى قربي فتب مما جنيت عسى تعود إلي